What is going on, guys? Kingpin Light here. We got Kong Daniel Paranoia lyrics. I did the color-coded lyrics because I've seen this particular style for a lot of other, I think, BTS and some of those videos. And I figured this might be the best way to really break down what I'm hearing for the first time. So, plus, sometimes when I do music videos alongside a song I've never heard, I just, there's too many things for me to focus on. There's the video, the lyrics, and then the overall sound. And especially with an artist that I'm not super familiar with, I've reacted to one song. I've only heard one song from him. So I just figured this would be a little less, overloading, simulating, or stimulation or whatever. But anyway, guys, let's go ahead and jump right into this. One sec. I don't need closed captioning because it's a lyric video. And yes, this was a comment suggestion, by the way. And I'm keeping a running list of all of the comments, and the ones that get pointed out more are going to be reacted to quicker now that I'm doing 3 days a week of reacting. So if you really like a song, make sure to, or you want to see a song reacted to, make sure to comment it, and like other people who like it or whatever, who comment it, so that I can know that that's a big one that you guys want. So anyway, let's jump right into it. What is that, Jay Gucci? That's the channel, right? Yep, I just checked. It's the channel. Okay, never mind. Right, he's got that real nice cinematic R&B. I don't know if that's the right phrase, but it makes sense in my head. That's kind of how I see him. All right, so it's called Paranoia. I'm going to pay attention to the lyrics. Days are as dark as the night. It's getting scary in my lightless room. So setting a nice, I think, atmosphere and sort of scenario situation that this song is going to take place in. Maybe it's a story. Okay, I'm really liking this flow right here. I'm guessing this is the bridge or maybe the hook itself, but really liking the flow, but obviously I didn't hear too much of it. I just wanted to pause and point out that production, man. Again, it's that real nice, dark R&B production. Very akin, like I said, to early Weekend, or maybe mid-Weekend, The Weekend, mid-career, I want to say. Maybe not really his new stuff, but I want to say almost... what's the one in I Can't Feel My Face? The one before that was Kissland, right? A little bit of Kissland inspired is what it kind of reminds me of. But anyway, let's keep going. So far, lyric-wise, I mean, I'm liking the lyrics, but I'm trying to figure out if there's a consistent theme. It just sounds like he's maybe talking about demons in general. I'm trying to figure out what the metaphor is, whether it's demons as in your own insecurities, or whether it's he's setting a storyline up, like it's real in the scenario of the song, you know what I mean? Like a storytelling, or whether it's both, right? Like a double entendre type of thing. I gotta say that my favorite part so far is this whole... the production and the voice and flow in this Close Your Eyes, the hook, basically. I really, really like that. But overall, he's got a great singing voice, so let's keep going. I just got to point that flow right there is nice. It's like a real bouncy sort of a pendulum style. If that makes sense. Cause, and I've heard this sort of style. I'm sure there's a better, like a real musical term for a lot of the stuff that I say. I'm not versed in all of the vocabulary of somebody who breaks down music, but I got to say, it just sounds like real swinging is what it sounds like. So maybe the demons he's speaking about are those specific feelings of paranoia, and maybe the paranoia is coming from maybe his career. Maybe he's got backstabbers, or he's got to watch his back. I don't know. I don't know the guy's, like, Kong Daniel's story or anything really about his career or anything like that. Or, to be honest, I don't really even know much about his art outside of this song and the other song that I've reacted to. Other than those two, I don't really know his story or his style, so... You guys let me know what he's referring to, if it is anything past surface level. I just want to point out, I'm drinking a rose lemonade. It's traditional botanical beverage with pure rose extract. This thing is bombing. The deepest lyrics are right here, bro. I'm just playing. I like that. I like how it sounds. I actually do. You know what it reminds me of? This little section, for some really, really odd reason. Like, if I close my eyes and picture, like, a scenario that this song would be playing in, it's like a horror movie set in a carnival for some weird reason. Like, it sounds a little carnival-y to me. A dark carnival, like, it fits the atmosphere that the song is supposed to set, I think. Ooh, that I like this section a whole lot. I like the voice production, right? The filters and effects and the sort of reverb and sort of staticky effect over it, like where it kind of blows out the how it sounds like when you blow out your speakers, that real blown out sound. I really like that effect on voices. And then just this whole section seems a little out of genre, that makes sense in a good way, where it doesn't seem very poppy and it doesn't seem very rap like either. I'm trying to figure out like what genre it would fit in, but honestly, like, alternative is all I can think of. It just sounds cool. That's cool. That's a cool sound. I keep hitting this desk, bro. Ooh. Oddly enough, that gives me some Kim Eminem vibes. You know, not the song itself, but like the little intro and outro sounds, like where he's walking or whatever. I like that whistling, though, for some reason. It just sounds really melodic. But yeah, guys, so that is Kong Daniel Paranoia, my reaction. As always, thank you guys for suggesting this. Thank you for watching if you stick to this very end. And I mentioned this. I keep forgetting to mention it, but I got a Discord if you guys want to talk. And I got my girlfriend and a couple other people on there right now. I keep forgetting to plug it, so I don't really have a whole lot of people on there yet, but... If you're one of the first 100 people, which could take the next 10 years for all I know, first 100 people will get a special tag. You'll be the OG of the Discord. But anyway, guys, thank you for watching. I will catch you guys on the next one. Take care.